Now that we've finished our potion sprite, I'd like to animate it to look like it's being consumed. But before we start with the animation, first we need to understand how to use layers in Piskel. Here's the potion we created in the first few tutorials. I want to animate this potion so that you can see it being used, with the potion being consumed over a few frames. To do this, I'm going to put the potion and the bottle on separate layers. An easy way to think of a layer is like a clear sheet of paper. You can draw on the sheet and then place another sheet on top of it. Since they're clear, you'll still be able to see the bottom sheet's art, and you'll be able to draw on the top sheet without altering what's underneath. The layers stack on top of each other, combining together to create the final image. The Layers panel is on the right side of the screen. Right now, we have one layer, called Layer 1. We can add another layer on top of that by pressing the plus sign, create a new layer. That places a new layer on top of the stack. You can reorder them by pressing these arrows, move layer up and move layer down. We can also edit the layer's name with this button. I'll set the bottom layer to be called Bottle, and the upper layer to be called Potion. This next button allows you to merge a layer with the layer directly below it. If you do this, you'll lose any pixels on the bottom layer that are behind pixels on the top layer. The pixels on the top layer will replace the pixels on the bottom layer. You can also delete a layer with the X, Delete Selected Layer. Last, you can change the opacity of a layer by clicking on this 1A icon. Once we get to the layers setup, I'll show you an example of the opacity. I want to cut the red potion out of the bottle layer and paste it into the potion layer. Let's continue exploring the tools that Piskel offers to see how we can do that. We need to select all of these red pixels, so the first option we have is the Shape Selection tool, which you can find here, or just press the Z shortcut. The Shape Selection tool selects all pixels of the same color that share at least one side. If I click on the darker shade of red, it selects all of the dark red pixels. And if I click on the light red pixels, it selects all of the light red pixels. That won't work for this example. We need to select both the dark and light red pixels. The next option is the Rectangle Selection tool, which you can find here, or just press the S shortcut. With the Rectangle Selection tool, you can drag a rectangle area out, which will select all pixels underneath. But because of the shape of this potion, we can't select all of the pixels at once. Unless we select some of the outline, we either have this single line on the top, or two lines on each side, which we can't select. So the Rectangle Selection tool won't work either. The last option we have is the Lasso Selection tool, which you can get here, or just press the H shortcut. With the Lasso tool, click and hold the mouse button and drag around the area you want to select. You can drag around the edges and easily select an irregular shape. Now I have the entire potion area selected. I can cut it and paste it on the potion layer. If I click between layers, the active layer is visible, while any other layer's opacity is lowered. This is only the case when creating your sprite. If you notice, in the upper right side, this is the actual preview, and the bottle and the potion are both fully opaque. This is what the sprite will look like when you save it. If you actually want to change the opacity of a layer, you can click here on the 1A, to the right of the layer name. Here, the opacity is set on a scale of 0 to 1, with 0 being transparent and 1 being fully opaque. To set the opacity to 50%, you would set this value to 0.5. For 25%, you'd set it to 0.25. Notice, in the sprite preview, the potion is transparent now. I'll set it to 0 for now, so it's fully transparent. Go ahead and select the bottle layer. Now, you can see the area where the potion was that needs to be shaded in. I'm going to use the same colors from the lip and the neck of the bottle. To select them, we'll use another tool, the color picker, which can be found here, or by pressing the O shortcut. The color picker lets you select a color for your primary and secondary colors by clicking on the color you'd like. So I'll select the primary color, by left-clicking on the darker glass, and the secondary color by right-clicking on the lighter glass. I'll press P to switch over to the pen tool, and I'll fill in the bottle with the primary color. And then the rest with the secondary color. Now we can turn the opacity of the potion layer back to 1. At this point, we have two finished layers, the bottle layer and the potion layer. In the next video, we'll animate this potion so that it's consumed over several frames. As it's consumed, it will reveal the empty bottle on the bottom layer. Thanks for watching. If you found this content helpful, please consider supporting me on Patreon. Comment, like, and share this video, and subscribe for more tutorials. See you next time.